Hello, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome back to Breath of the Wild. Today we are carrying on with our Korok collecting quest. Today we are doing the Tabantha region. So the entire region in one video. So that includes this whole area here. It includes the area around Rito Village. So it might be a little bit of a long one, but it's too short to split into two. So it's all going to be one video. There are 37 Korok seeds in this region, which means at the end of this, I should have 574 total and 198 in my pocket. And this is what you should have if you've turned in all the ones you currently can up to this point. I've upgraded my inventory all the way. So without any further ado, let's get started with it. So the first one of the episode is going to be, I believe it's a timer challenge, it looks like, across the bridge. There we are. So honestly, the easiest way to do this is probably step on it. Revali's gale your way back up. And then glide over, or grab the bike or the horse or something. So this is the first one I've recorded after we finished basically the game. Done everything except for the finale. So we have all the shrines taken care of. So I have the Armor of the Wild on right now just because it looks nice. Yeah, haha. Got a rare ore here. And the next one is going to be to the right of the bridge. Ooh, nice. So yeah. As of now, we've got all 120 shrines, which means I can do all the Korok videos now. I'm not going to quite marathon them, but I'm going to do a few at a time. Today I'm going to do at least this one. I might do Hebra today, which is going to be a kind of a pain in the ass, to be honest with you. Oh, hey. Actually, hang on. Quick detour. What do I need from our good old buddy, old pal, Dinral? I don't have anything from Dinral, right? Yeah, not one thing except the fang, so going to grab, might cut this out, or at least me getting back up. I didn't grab the ancient bow. I should maybe go get that and cut that part out too. That's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna shoot this guy, this little fella here, grab the scale, and then I'm gonna warp away, go grab a new ancient bow actually, because I broke the old one, and then I'll cut back to being up there. So one moment. All right, we are back in business. I have the ancient bow. I also bought a few ancient arrows, just in case. That's not where I want to go. I should climb up a bit. So we're heading around the back side here of Piper Ridge, which is where the Great Fairy Fountain is. And there's a little offering bowl down here. Isn't that cute? This one's pretty well hidden, actually. I wonder if this becomes a cave entrance in Tears of the Kingdom. It probably does, knowing them. It's kind of a little cave already, but in that game, they take little areas that are kind of cave-ish. There's like a little overhang or something, and they make them an actual full cave. Pretty neat. Should check. You know what? I'm just gonna use Revali's Gale. You can climb this wall if you want to, but why would you do that? You can just Revali's Gale it up. Okay. Alright. Well, thank God I got that ancient bow. Probably should have bought more arrows while I was away, but whatever. I'll find more. Nice. Alright. And now we head down sort of toward the tower. There's a little camp down there. We're going to go over that. You can fight him if you want. Could be fun. But I'm going to not do that. Hey! Forget about it. It's a great fairy fountain. I would stop if I wasn't in the middle of a Korok video. Right here. There's a bit of a timer challenge. Cool. Alright, now got two over here. There's one sort of in the crev, it looks like. You know what I mean, in the crev. Look at this. It's so rude. Those damn game developers. So mean. Yeah, so next time is going to be the first part of Hebra, which is going to be a bit of a nuisance. Actually, of all the parts of Hebra, it's going to be the least of a nuisance. The second and third part are going to suck. I'm starting with the flat area to the east. I'm going for, like, the stable and that sort of field. Oh, my God. I just want to push it over a little bump, and I can't even do that properly. But yeah, the second and third parts are like the mountains, the actual mountains. So that's going to be a bit of a problem, especially number part three. That's ugh. There really is no like elegant way to do Hebra. No matter what you do, you're going to either be warping back to the same shrine a couple times and gliding down in different directions, or climbing up, like, sheer cliffs. It's just... it's so annoying. Hebra's so annoying. Get out of here. Asshole. Bye. Alright, so now we're going to kind of climb up, sort of like we're going to go to the tower. But we're not actually going to go to the tower. Whoa, it's like we're gonna bonk into walls and almost kill ourselves with a motorcycle. Imagine being the hero of legend and you die in a motorcycle accident. Like, you really should be wearing a helmet. Oh, jeez. I should be wearing Majora's Mask is what I should really be doing. This armor gives me, like, no defense, but I don't care. It looks cool. Who needs defense? You gotta look your best if you're gonna be climbing a tower like this. Okay, so this is off the edge, I believe. Let's take a gander. Yeah, it's over... there's only one on this actual hill, and it's down here. I do believe. Yeah, right over here. An eyeball. And behind the eyeball is a rock. Under the rock is a Korok. You missed, you idiot. Free sword, and yeah. Nice. Idiot. All right, now we're going to jump off this hill and go over to that crater, I believe. The Talus down there, I think. We're just going to leave him alone. Leave him out of this. Actually, maybe I should kill him. I want to see what kind he is. If he's a, if he has the little, like, stone on his back, I'm going to say, fuck it, and leave him. But if he's, like, just an ordinary old Talus with a rare ore or something on it, then be a shame not to just knock him out. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, that's a go. Ugh. Idiot. Gotta be, like, iron in there or something for it to be damaged by electricity. Some kind of metal. Please, please, please. Be nice. Thank you. Whew. Hoping he wouldn't throw me off. And he did not. How nice of him. Ooh, diamond. That was worth it. That was worth the time. It barely took any time at all. His little detour, and now I have, I think, 8 diamonds in my pockets. 9 of them. God damn, I should sell those. Did I just pick up 2? I think I just picked up 2. In which case, that's a really rare ore deposit right there. That's a good one. Alright. Wow, that's a lot of rocks. Okay, where's the gap? There is no gap. Not that I see anyway, so I'm just gonna put it in the middle. Wow, you guys really wanna eat my ass, don't you? Not on the menu, sorry. Yep, just put it in the middle. Okay. There is no gap. Haha. Alright, you wanna tussle, big man? You wanna tussle? Fuck you up. Fuck you up and eat your jellies. Some weird lighting on that guy. Look at it, he's glitching out with coloring. That's weird. I broke the game somehow by existing. Alright, there's a little clump of trees over yonder. Yeah. I believe that's a little stump in the middle, so it's probably a ball and chain. I'm going to resist the temptation to hold the left bumper to change the rune here. Because again, I'm going back and forth between Tears of the Kingdom and this game. It's making it very confusing for me. See, I just try to go to the bike. That's not how you do it. Alright. Now we are going to move in the general direction of the ancient columns. I see you. There's a little offering bowl here. This is a benefit to your bike. Brought a horse here, he'd try to eat the apples out of the bowls, but bikes can't eat apples. Silly. Yeah. Yeah. Alright, yeah, time to start heading up this hill here. There's actually a pillar right there. I'm gonna go up there. You can climb it, but I'm gonna Revali's Gale up to the top. Because I am way too lazy to climb that. It's a nice little elevated area right next to it, so I can just hop on there and Revali's Gale my way to the top. Ooh, scary. Alright. Yeah, haha. Alright, now I'm gonna head all the way to the very top, basically, to the actual ancient columns. This is where there is a Gliok in Tears of the Kingdom. So this is definitely a no-no zone. Let's just call it that. Don't go here early on, or you will get absolutely fucked. In this game, though, you're fine. Not that scary. I believe it's a timer challenge somewhere. Actually, is it here? Might be here.
Urbosa's fury is ready.
Yep, thanks for that. Very nice of you. No. Oh, there it is. There's two up here, actually. Timer challenge here. I'm gonna save Revali's Gale for now. This one's not that tall. And I got so much stamina. Alright, now at the very top next to the shrine, there is a little... Actually, I think it's right there. A little circle of flowers in the water. Don't look at me. I'm not here. Yeah, right there. This is where we were like, excuse me, princess. Essentially. She got all pissy with us for doing our jobs. Ma'am, I just work here. Okay. And now that that's done, I can grab onto a random surface, as usual. Glide down sort of this direction. There's one more on this hill, then I'm going to warp over to the tower and move my way north. 20 minutes. It's probably going to be like over an hour for this one, because it's a longer video, but like I said, if I split it into two, that would be like maybe, what, 15 to 17 Koroks for each episode. That's like way too short. That would be just lame. So, Tabantha is one of the few areas where I'm going to do the entire thing in one video. I think there are four regions where I'm going to do that. There's a Great Plateau, which was only 18 Koroks anyway, so that was really short. Did that one like 2-3 years ago, basically, at this point. This one, the Woodland Tower, and the Gerudo Highlands. Each of those is going to be only one video. The Gerudo Highlands might be a pain in the ass, because there's not a lot of Koroks there, but they are quite difficult and very spread out. So, I think I've gone too far. No, I have not. There it is. This one's going in the star pattern that I was saying before. In a previous video, I was like, why didn't it go in like in a star pattern, like how you draw a star? That one did. Okay, so they did do that eventually. Okay, good. That was... would have been a missed opportunity if it didn't do that. All right, we're going to go to the Tabantha Tower and glide off to the east, follow the road up toward Rito Village. Things get a little convoluted once you get up to Rito Village, because there's just so many areas to go to, so many different directions. There's the village itself. There's the... there's like one over by Hebra for some reason. Just one. Wow. It's chilly. There's the road. Okay, there's one kind of off the edge. Next to the canyon. I'm gonna try to get that one by like falling in the canyon and like completely, because I don't want to drive to climb back out or warp back to the top again. Yeah, that whole mess over there is next. I can hardly wait. I think once I get through that in the Gerudo Highlands, it'll actually be seeming very manageable from there on. I mean, Central Tower is not that bad. It's actually pretty easy. It's all flat. So, watch this. Oh, damn it. Fine, I'll grab this one. What? Oh, you can just go right through that. That's stupid. trying to grab that little, like, bone thing. I'd climb myself up, but it's not working. Never mind. I don't want your stupid chest anyway. Doesn't matter. It's probably garbage. Probably stupid. Nice. That rare ore deposit gave me flint. Very nice. Exactly what I wanted. Super cool. I think I'm a little too high up still. Is it here? I think that's it. I should make sure this is the right one before I grab it. Fairly certain, though. That's it. We got it. Pull that up. Okay, we're back.
Yay.
All right. Sorry. I'm gonna... You can probably go to that ledge over there and then climb our way back up. I'm just gonna Revali's Gale. My way back up. Too high. I think there's like an updraft over there or something you can use to get back up as well. So this is this area, that rickety ass bridge up there, is actually Kolami Bridge. If you're not aware, Kolami is the Rito prince, right? Son of the Rito chief in Wind Waker. So pretty cool. Always cool to see those other characters referenced. I think every one of the areas has at least one area like referencing a character from that, like that race in a different game. So like in Zoro's domain, like in the area near it, there's Rallus Pond. Rallus is the Zoro prince from Twilight Princess. Oh my god, can you suck my dick, please? I should... No, don't do that. That would be weird. Just leave me the fuck alone. Idiot. Now they're all gonna be on my ass. This is all your fault, Yiga Clan. Yiga and the Keys. Fuck it. Fuck it. I'm just gonna grab this and go. Run for it. Yes. You know what? No Revali's Gale. Great. Wait a second. It's almost back. Can you stop?
Revali's Gale is now ready.
I fucking wasted it. Now you're dying. I was gonna leave you alone, but now you're dying. Now I'm gonna enjoy it. Ugh. It actually counted as one, too. That's so dumb. Oh my god, and it's gonna make me go backwards. Great. Fucking lovely. Great game. 10 out of 10. Okay, maybe this was not the best way to do this, but... I mean, I gotta get back up there. So you may have to just climb there. I'm trying to think if it'd be better to like go up here and then go down later, but I don't think so, because you're gonna want some height to glide out into the middle of that lake. So I don't know. You may have to just suck it up and climb, to be honest. Well, that was irritating. That was extremely annoying. What you might be able to do, actually, is there's a ledge over there. If you could, like, Revali's Gale your way over to that, maybe, or just glide over to it, and then go up from there. I don't know. Or Revali's Gale on that side, probably. Because then the wind will blow you into the wall, so you'll just grab it. That's probably the best way to do it. I don't know. You figure it out. Basically, you got to get down there, grab that Korok seed, and come back up somehow. Use a travel medallion if you want to. Oh, actually, you'll start down, so I don't know. Figure it out. Use your brain. You can do it. If it weren't for that wind, Revali's Gale would be a great option, but kind of blows you away from the side of the cliff if you're where I was, so. Either way, somehow I gotta get back up here so you can get to this tree. I can't believe that shit. Might add more time to weigh my options and make a good decision if I wasn't being attacked by Lizalfos the whole time, but you know. Canon next things, so here we are. I would go after Dinral, but I've already gotten him once and I'm kind of in the middle of something here, so he'll be fine. Yeah, actually, I was thinking, yeah, maybe you should just go for that one first, but no, because either way, you're going to have to get back up at some point. Because if you go for the one in the canyon first, you're going to be down below the bridge, so yeah, there's no reason to go for that tree first. Just, I don't know, figure it out. I think if you went to the right of the bridge, if you're looking, like, this way. So if you go, like, in this corner and use Revali's Gale, you should be fine. Because the breeze will blow you into the wall. So then just grab it, and then you can climb back up that way. Alright, so now we're heading to the middle of this lake. Strock Lake. Interesting name. And there is a gale here. There's also treasure. Treasure. Some booty. Ooh. 100 bucks. I have very little money for this late in the game because I spent all of it on random shit. The ancient bow. Bought some ancient arrows. Okay, what am I actually looking for here? There it is. A little tunnel. Free shit. Topaz. I should sell all my stuff after this video. I have so much stuff I can sell. Korok seed. Okay, cool. Do that. And then I don't want to cross the river or the lake the rest of the way, I believe, right over there. You didn't just see me commit murder, did you? Nope. You're just in my way as always. Uh-oh. That was a threat, apparently. Leave me alone. Alright. So then, there's one more in this lake. It's actually on the other side, but it involves jumping into the lake, which makes getting back out kind of a pain in the ass. So, definitely go for this one last. And now we're basically right here at Rito Village. So, it's pretty sick. After this, we're going to warp to Meadow. Because there are a few Rito Village, but they're actually pretty high up, so you're going to want to start high up. And then there's actually more on the pillars surrounding Rito Village than in the village itself. So that's where we're going to go next. Whoa, take it easy there. Alright, over here somewhere there should be a circle of flowers. Lily pads, I guess. Something. Sploosh. And you want to do this one last because now you're in the lake and I don't want to climb back out, so I'm just going to warp out. Alright, just to confirm, I am going to Rito Village, yes. All right. All right. Oh, look at that. So pretty. All right, so up here, there is this hole in the rock, the heart-shaped hole in the rock, and there is a balloon in there, I do believe. Yep. Gonna land first so I don't keep falling. All right, there's one more in the actual village. Actually, I suppose it's the same amount in the village and the surrounding pillars. There's one there. There's one, I think that's probably that thing. Seems very Korok-y to me. Yeah. Cool, now we can climb up high enough just to make it to the pillars that we need to get to. So we're going to this big one. Okay, so let's just climb up to the very top of the village. Brief detour through the lovely Rito Village. How nice. Well, I'm here. I'm gonna take all your money. Like how the shop owners in this game have literally infinite money. You can just be like, hey, how about 4,500 rupees? How about that? Sounds good. All right. Where am I at with upgrading shit? That's a three, that's a three. I only need 10 more sapphires and I need all 15 of the rubies. Okay. Or, other way around. So, I need 15 sapphires. I can still sell 9. And I can sell 9 of these two. Sorry, brief diversion, but figure I may as well sell some shit, get some money. It's satisfying. Probably cut this part out. Or speed it up or something. Good enough. I am no longer poor. Actually, I am incredibly rich now. Cool. I love Rito Village. It's just really, really nice. It's very simple, but it's, I don't know, it's good. And the music is lovely. It's just great. Okay, where's the thing I'm trying to get to? Also, hello. I wonder if he'll be important. Oh, wow, yeah, that's way up there. I'm gonna use a Revali's Gale. Whoa, that pot went flying. Yeah, it might actually almost be good to just warp to the top again, but I mean, if you've got two Revali's Gales, you could just go over here and then land on this thing and then do it again. But I have used my last Revali's Gale. If I didn't waste that one, I could have done this much faster, but oh well. These pillars are pretty climb-friendly. There's a lot of little ledges here, so makes sense. Birds like to hang out here, so birds typically like to have places to land. They don't fly forever. Fun fact about birds, they don't fly forever. Yeah. I bet you're amazed. Okay. What is this commentary? Alright, offering bowl, and then I believe this is a timer challenge, and I can warp back to the village. Right there. Again, the best strategy for these is just work top to bottom. So start high, work our way back down. So I started at the very top with the balloon in the little heart-shaped hole. Work our way down. This pillar. Honestly, what might be a better idea is go from there to this pillar to I guess both of the pillars, because then you're gonna have to warp back to the top anyway. So just go back up here and then get the rock. I might move those around, to be honest. It's a better order. Probably should have I would have tested these like in game before I recorded them, but that would mean getting all the Koroks again. That would be so much work. It's easier to just edit them and move stuff around if I need to. Yeah, I'd say do that. And then we're back to the top there. Right over here. Grab this Korok seed. Then head down to the stable. Now, when you get to the stable, I recommend putting a travel medallion down. You don't have to. If you don't have it, you can just, when you come back to the stable, you can just go back to the village shrine and then glide down again. But seems like kind of a waste of time. If you have the travel medallion, just slap it down. It will save you time in the long run. Because now we're going to go out of our way, because there's this one seed that's technically in the Tavantha region, even though it basically is a Hebra section of the map. But we're going to grab it now. It's very out of the way. So to avoid having to spend a whole minute getting back here afterwards, I'm just going to slap that down. Okay. I believe yeah, I believe this way is it. We're going to Hebra Plunge. Which again, it has Hebra in the name. You'd think it would be in the Hebra region, but technically this whole lake is actually Tavantha for some reason, so I don't make the rules. I just draw lines on the map and follow them. Damn it. Wasn't even a rare one. Don't care. Oh my god, I'm so sorry. Right there. Oh, suddenly I'm chilly. Alright. Now we're gonna get into some snowy areas. Probably should put on my warm clothes. We're gonna basically make a loop around the village to the north. Beetle. All right. Yeah, as much as I love the armor of the wild, I'm going to wear my snow quill stuff. Probably should try to upgrade this as much as I can before I go to do the Hebra Koroks. Might do that. All right, first we're going to get one from this big old tree. Now, this is one of those trees that you see this, you got to climb it. You got to see there's something up there, because that is a gigantic tree. Very, very large. All right. Let's see. Yeah, it's going to get cold here in a sec. This one's probably easy to miss. No, it's not. It's on a little ledge. Probably be pretty obvious. Yep, up there. I should be wearing my snow pants. Snow boots. For my own sanity. Also, do I have any speed stuff? I do not. I should have made some. I'm gonna have to wear... Take off the mask. So as to not freeze. You can't be warm and run fast and be immune to monsters at the same time. That's just too much power. Can't have it. Shame. All right, now we're gonna head up to the flight range. Yeah, get used to this view here, because you're going to be seeing a lot of that in the next, like, three videos that follow this one. A lot of snowy... Blech. Yuck. Not a lot of visibility. Like, at all. All right, now there's one on the roof of the actual flight range itself. Give me a boost. Not enough, damn it. Cool. Alright, there's one sort of bordering Hebra as well. It's Lake Kelsey, which we just took care of in the main playthrough. Well, it's the last area of Hebra we did in the main playthrough. Let's see. Okay, I believe it starts, like, down here somewhere. It's so hard to see, dude. It's so hard to see. I think I may have gone too far this time. Ugh, this is so annoying. I hate the snowy areas. This game. Yeah, I went way too far down. It's like, starts lower, but it can't be that low. I'm looking for one of those little flowers. I'm pretty sure. Unless I'm totally forgetting that there's a different one here. But I'm pretty sure it's the flower. Is that it over there? That's it. Yeah, look at that. That's so mean. How the fuck are you supposed to find that on your own? That's too hidden. Jeez. Again, Nintendo employee had a really bad day and took it out on the player here. Because this is just unfair. How the fuck are you supposed to find that? I got stamina food. I'm just going to jump. Too impatient for this. And it almost cost me everything that I love. Ugh. That was exhausting. Make sure that was in fact the right one. Probably should have made sure before I did it, but yeah, there's only one in this area. Alright. Now we climb back up. Now this is the annoying one, because there's a couple more. They're kind of bordering Hebra. There's a rock pattern right there. Oops. Mark that so I know where the fuck I'm going. It's hard to like even keep track of like where you're facing sometimes in this area, because it's like the visibility is so poor. You're like, okay, what land formations are even around me right now? I can't even tell what the fuck I'm looking at. Get my stamina back. Honestly, probably should have just used Revali's Gale here. This cliff is too steep. It's not really an easier way to do this. I mean, if you go from the other side as well, like if you're in Hebra and you go for this one, you gotta climb up the stupid cliff to get to the flower in the first place. So, no matter what, it's kind of a pain in the ass. Almost would be better to just go back to the flight range. Just warp back there and then ride over to where I'm going. It's probably not much slower. You get used to that kind of stuff a lot, because it's going to be all Hebra is just... There's no good way to do any of it. It's just a mess. And the Gerudo Highlands are not much better. I have to bend over backwards to find good routes for those. Oh my god, it's clearing up. Oh my god, it's actually sunny. Take advantage of this. It's not going to be sunny for long. It's never sunny for long. Right there. Yeah, definitely use the snow boots if you have them here, because otherwise carrying those is going to take forever. Because you're slowed down because of the rock, and you're also slowed down because snow is apparently just that hard to walk through. Yeah. Like deep snow, yeah, I get it. Doesn't seem that deep, to be honest. But what do I know? Alright, now this one is the one that's gonna seem like I'm going like just way out of the way. Cause it's weird. It's a timer challenge that starts actually in the Hebra region and ends in Tabantha. So I am gonna be going pretty far into Hebra here. There's also a Lionel, I believe, in the way, so hopefully I don't trigger him. Probably just Ancient Arrow, to be honest, if I tries to attack me. I'll just use an Ancient Arrow. I do not have the patience to fight a fucking Lionel right now. This video is already almost an hour long. I'm getting there, though. I'm almost done. Jeez, where's the frickin' path up here? There's a nice convenient path that leads up this, but having trouble finding it. You know what, just right up the sheer cliff, I don't care. Or don't, fine, fuck you. There's the Lionel. I need silver, of course. I don't need Hinox toenails for anything, do I? They're probably good fuel. Not really, actually. They kind of suck. Fine. I'm just going to keep using salt. Salt-powered vehicle. I mean, technically, like, sodium in like a pure form, oh my god, like explodes in water, right? So if you could like break it down, take the sodium out and then put it in water, that could probably propel a bike. Probably kill you, to be honest, but I mean, I don't know how violent of an explosion it is. Maybe you could use it to power a bike. What do I know? I'm no chemist. But then the exhaust would probably just be pure chlorine, which is toxic, so I don't know, it seems really bad. Salt-powered vehicles, probably not a good idea. Probably. I mean, you think we're destroying the environment already, but if we have a chlorine exhaust, then Jesus. Alright, yeah, look at this. We're so far into Hebra, here's where the freaking timer challenge starts. There it is. Ooh, a free goodie for my troubles. I wish I had Tulin. Let's Tori Mountain. It's going. Alright. Yeah, so we're gonna do this one, and then we only have a couple left, I think. We're gonna basically have a couple on the very edge of the map, and then Wobbler's Nest. That's pretty much it. Probably faster if you use the bike here, but too late. Too late. Alright. And you can leave me alone. Actually, I probably need your tail for something, right? And you can piss off. Jeez. I fucking hate the keys. I hate them. I'm gonna revise Gale my way back up here. This is nothing, right? This is just a amber. Yeah, it's a little less chilly, so I'm gonna put the mask back on real fast. I don't want to deal with these motherfuckers. So up here, there's a little mountain that's kind of broken into three pieces, like a little crack down the middle of it. I believe the middle is not the Korok. The middle is just a... nothing, apparently. On top of one of these things is the Korok. There it is. Alright, now we're going to go to Dragonbone Mire, which is an area that literally has zero significance other than this one Korok seed, so that's pretty cool. They call it Dragonbone Mire, but I feel like all the skeletons here feel like they're just the whale bones. I mean, I don't know. It could be any. I guess it could be any kind of rib cage. Hard to tell if there's no head on it. But imagine there's three leviathans, right? Imagine they're the remnants of like the wind fish, the what's his name from Wind Waker, the guy who gives you the last pearl, I forget his name, and Lord Jabu Jabu, like the like legendary like sacred whales from the other games. They're all dead, and it's all their bones or something. I don't know. Imagine that. It's very upsetting to think about. What the hell is his name? I remember Velu and the Deku tree. There's like a third one. There's that big old fish in the back of Outside Island in Wind Waker. I can't remember the name anymore. There are too many names in this Zelda series. I can't remember all of them. Not an encyclopedia. So we're gonna head up to Warbler's Nest. There's three Korok seeds left in this area. First of all, though, very important, yummy peppers. All right. There's a lot of ingredients here. Cool. All right. Anyway. That's not it yet. I think there's another one. I thought there was, anyway. Yep, there is. He's trying to trick me. You can't fool me that easily. Yeah. We will get to that little flower trail in a second. This one's weird. It's like a pentagon shape. Yeah, it's a pentagon. Looks like kind of a lumpy circle. But it is, in fact, a pentagon. All right, now the flower trail. I see those. Another rush room. I'm gonna need a lot of these. I have to farm off screen. I only have 20 more, I guess, but still, it's a lot. Didn't roll. All right, and there should be only one more left, and it will be over here. Got to put back on my cold hat. Yep, it's a bit chilly. Damn it, I wanted to grab that. Thanks, buddy. Bye-bye. No. Alright. It's kind of a hole up here, and in the hole is the Korok seed. Yep, down here. Got a little cult here of offering bowls. That's cute. And look closely, those are not apples. Those are, in fact, hot peppers. Spicy pepper. Lovely. And that should be the last one. So real fast, I need to check where is my starting point for the next one. Okay. Alright, it's gonna be kind of a weird starting point for this next one. But let's see, where's the best place to go for this? I do believe the best place is probably this DLC shrine. If you don't have it, you can go to the tower, the Bridgestone Tower, and fly over here. But I'm gonna start with going to this DLC shrine. Odd location, I know, but it'll make sense. I promise. Alright, that's 574, which is exactly how many I should have, right about an hour. So, kind of a long episode, but I did the entirety of Tabantha in this video, so there you go. Next time, we begin the trial that is Hebra Korox. So, stay tuned for that. It's going to be rough, but, oh my god, until then, let me know in the comments if you had any trouble with any Koroks, any other comments or concerns, and I will see you in the next one. Bye-bye.